What is good, everybody? So today is the vlog you've all been waiting for, and your boy is gonna be going to Senegal. So typical mom stuff. So your boy's gonna be going to Senegal, and so I'm heading to the airport, so that's why I've been keeping low key. And yeah, it's gonna be pretty interesting. Like, I have to go get my results of the COVID test, so hopefully that'll turn out positive, negative actually, and we'll be able to fly out. So I have luggages of Annie and Julia with me, so here they are. This is Julio's, which is the golden one, Manny, and then I have one of to my surprise, these guys really pack a lot of stuff to go. Man, I just have my luggage, and it probably weighs like 17 kilograms. I'm gonna go, I'll weigh it, and I'm sure it's gonna, I have 40 kilograms in total, and I'm sure right now, like, I have like 60 on my hands, so I'm gonna have to pay extra. And I have no choice, so yeah. But since there's not many people that are gonna be boarding the plane, that means we can overload and just pay extra. So there, let's see how it goes. So do I start off with the good news or the bad news? Nah, fuck it, good news. Good news is that I tested negative for COVID.
Yeah.
Bad news is that my flight, I missed my flight. All because of the stupid test. Now, it is my fault as well. Like, I came a bit late for the airport, so they were closing down. So by the time I went to get my test from the airport, they said, sorry, everybody embarked on the plane, so you're gonna have to push your flight. I won't lie, I'm mad. So yeah, they said to come tomorrow, 7:30 a.m. And yeah, let's see how it goes. Morning, guys. So day two. 7 a.m. right now. So yeah, I came in super early, so I won't have to deal with any kind of bullshit, any kind of complications again, so I have to run around. So yeah, I'm here super early, and I guess today was actually smoother. Like, I guess when you come earlier, they don't really bother you that much, but when they see a lot of people and all that stuff, like, they get really handsy with, like, having them tip them and all that kind of stuff. This is something I don't really like about Togo. For example, they'll see a guy like me, young, and they feel like, okay, he probably has money because he's like, he's a young upcoming star or something like that. And they want to poke you so you can bribe them or give them any kind of money. I'm like, okay, if they see white people, they will never tell them to bribe them. They'll never even address them. They'll just like salute them and even bow. If they see a African man, like old middle age, and he has wearing a suit, they won't even bother him at all. They also like salute him and all that stuff. If they see like a really high celebrity, like for example, Adebayor, they're not gonna bother him because they expect him to give them money, but they respect him by keeping some distance and just like respecting him from the distance, you know? So I'm like, what makes me any different? Like, if you don't really ask me for money and you're just like, help me out and you do everything, I'll give you my own will, you know? But like, when you just come and poke me like, what, yo, I need my morning coffee. Who does that? General rule of thumb, when you're here at this airport, if you're doing the transit or you're actually coming here or something like that, always have a pen with you, okay? If you have a hard time reading French, then I suggest that you have someone to just translate for you in French, okay? That person, you're gonna have to tip them, of course, but it's not gonna be too much. Another one, you get your own strolley and you put yourself on your own strolley. I suggest you not to really get all these kind of people, because honestly, they always expect something from you. And when you also, like, when you're picking up your baggages, when you're claiming your baggages, also claim it yourself. Don't really have somebody do it for you, because it's very useless. It's something you can do on your own. It's very easy, you know? If you're a female and you have heavy luggages, then okay, I get you. But apart from that, I think you're good to go. And yeah, those are the basics of basics. And let's see how it goes. I'm waiting for the agency so I can pay for my penalty for missing my flight. And see you on the flip side. Okay, two more things I forgot. There's people that will be recommending you to put plastic around your baggages. They always have that service here. Don't even bother, it's a waste of money. And you can always weigh your own luggages. Like, the weight scale is over there, so you can just do it yourself. And always kind of ask you for money, all that kind of stuff. And lastly, I believe that once you come in and they start like checking in your luggages and they're seeing what's inside it and everything, those guys are the people that you actually have to tip, because most of the time, sometimes you might have something that shouldn't be there, but it's okay, they'll let it slide. It's not something that dangerous, you know what I mean? Like liquids or something like that. They're just saying, okay, whatever, pass, whatever. You know what I mean? So those people, they help you a lot. So thank goodness for these kind of guys. These guys deserve it. Apart from that, you're good to go. All right, guys. So see you there. So guys, good news this time. So we made it through. Now we're on the boarding. So yeah, I'm waiting for the plane to show up. So. Here I am. Bus is here. There's a plane over there. I don't know if you guys can see it. So yeah. So it's pretty interesting going to a whole new African country I've never been to. I've never been to Senegal, so it's gonna be a nice experience. So let's see how it goes. Manny has a lot of plans over there. He wants to film a lot of stuff. So I'm also gonna take advantage. And yeah, the songs are being prepared and they're being mastered. So I believe as of next week, we'll have the first song that we did out, and we'll have the other ones just like coming up afterwards. So yeah, I did a preview for some of my friends about the song of Lebanon. Like, it's, I just dedicated to Lebanon a bit, but the actual song is dedicated to my friends that I grew up with in Lebanon. Like, it's called Blood, Sweat and Tears. So I was fond of it, and I made some of the boys that were involved in it hear it, and it brought me almost to tears that they were so emotional about it. They're so like, they're now already repeating the chorus in their heads. I'm like, wow, okay, that's amazing. So I can't wait for you guys to hear this out as well.
Feeling so, so great. I believe in magic. The thing you do me not the matter. Oh. I dey feel I make a maintain. Oh. Say for the bed, do I be father. Oh. I'ma show my cool me down. Whoa, whoa. Cool me down, down, down. Yeah, yeah. Cool me down. Whoa, whoa. Cool me down. I'm all a shape body, oh, 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 shape body. I'm my baby, me shape body, oh, 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 shape body. Oh, kilo, shape body, oh, 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 shape body. I'm my baby, me, I'm a me, oh. I'm a show my cool me down. Whoa, whoa, cool me down.
She's like really, really horrible.
God damn.
Wow, look at this candy house, man. Whoa.
Hey.
Julio! Julio!
What's up? Hey, so what?
Whoa, man, we all cool here now.
Shit.
Hey,
so your boy finally made it to, wait, it's fucking through. Okay, yeah, so your boy made it. It's been a crazy ass flight. So yeah, money in the car. This place is pretty fucking nice.
Whoa, so this place is actually cool, man.
The whole
yeah,
family's
so
here.
So We all gonna be cool here today.
The whole gang is here. And we have Chris Brown as well, right?
Yeah, Chris Brown.
Hey guys, it's well.
This is where your boy's gonna be sleeping for a while. Yeah, he's gonna be sleeping here. Julio! So yeah, compared to the guys, I only had one luggage. Now let me show you their luggage. Okay, give me a second. Okay. Let me show you how much they were carrying. Okay. So he had this one, I got him for him. And he had that one. Okay? Now your boy Manny.
Okay, I don't got
Boy, Manny, I gotta see how many. Okay.
Hey.
One.
Hey.
Two.
Two.
Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. No. No. Yo.
He just like 1,000 pounds. He just like 1,000 pounds. I don't think about all things.
Bro.
Woo.
Eight.
They can do all these.
So you sprayed some bug spray on his head.
Bro, they all go sick again, so I
thought
I sprayed
on. Oh my god.
You know what I'm saying? I'm so bad. Hey, Julio! Look at Julio here. Julio, do.
I feel like we're gonna turn this into Big Brother House Dakar edition. So we about to try out some pizza from Dakar.
You don't like.
No, it's not good. Rubber is good. But this is glass. Soon to break. Soon to break. It will not last at all.
It tastes like those pizzas that you buy at the supermarket, the frozen pizzas. Yeah, but it tastes like weird frozen pizza.
You don't like it?
No.
You like the pizza? No.
Let me show you.
The
guy is very fat. Wait, you don't see her skin? Look pretty gay type later. Wait, let me show you.
Okay.
You wait, let me show you the gay. Ah, you don't check your food again?
No.
Because of the gay. She's very fat. Okay, bring it.
Big Brother House. Yo, what's good guys? It's day two and here I am, Julio. And he's taking us a tour, giving us a tour about Senegal. And look at this huge monument. If you guys ever seen this monument? Yeah, this is the famous one that we've all seen. And honestly, trust me, it seems decently big, but it's much bigger than you expect. Like, if I try to take a picture, I'll show you guys how big it is compared to a human being. The boy Judy will do anything for a picture.
Hello!
You see? So this guy found a road to be able to take a picture from here because we weren't allowed to take pictures because of the quarantine and everything. So now he found a solution for us. And other people also found the solution with him. They followed him.
Yep.
There you go. So now we're trying to go to this baobab tree over there so we can take some pictures. And he's still finding us ways to get there.
Hello guys!
Once you have a will, you'll find a way. What a baobab tree looks like. I actually never seen it up close, so I never knew that they had these kind of roots. This massive chunk of root. It's pretty thick. So yeah. Influencer stuff. Influencer stuff part two.
Faut que le poids de l'autre côté, de ce côté, soit le même. Le poids de mon côté, de l'autre côté.
Luc, essaie de me tenir comme ça.
I'm telling you guys, he'll do anything to get the right picture.
Hello!
Anything.
Now you understand what I mean? You have to climb on the tree.
What's good, everyone? I hope you guys enjoyed that vlog. It was pretty interesting. So yeah, I think I'm gonna end it here, and we'll do another vlog in Dakar coming up soon. We have a lot of plans here. It's gonna be very interesting. So yeah, I'm gonna be scrapping up this video right now so I can prepare for you guys to check it out and everything. And I have other videos that I still didn't complete, and it's gonna be coming out very soon as well. So yeah, stay tuned, guys. It's gonna be very good. See you soon.